Blessed Sunday to us. There are so many aspects or angles that we can actually talk about in order to give sense to this very interesting section of the gospel reading towards the end of the so-called ministry of Jesus, inasmuch as the Gospel of Mark is concerned. Because these are what we call the words that he said before he suffered, died, was buried, resurrected from the dead, and ascended to heaven. Now, in other words, we are very, very close to the so-called end of the liturgical calendar. Although, at the back of it, it's also a way of projecting the message of each and every liturgical year, that towards this part of the calendar, we are also reminded of the end of all of us, of each one of us, and of course, the world, which the gospel reading also is talking about. Now, I don't know, I'm so curious. What do you feel when you look at your calendars at this time of the year? Unsa may inyong bation, magtan-aw mo sa inyong kalendaryo. Uy, nipis na. O, usa na lang ka page, o duha na lang ka page, no? Now, my next question is, where did you place the other pages of the calendar? In the trash box, in the bin. You know, sometimes we may not really realize, okay, that there are so many important things in our lives that we just get out of the calendar, take out of the calendar, and then throw it in the garbage. And this is one beautiful message when we come at this very moment of our liturgical year. It is a reminder that all things end, but not losing sight that in every end, there is always a beginning. Ang makapahadlok manggod nato, maonga, the end is the end, no? That there is nothing more after the end. But our Christian faith always puts us into proper perspective because in every end, there is always a new beginning. Now, let me demonstrate this from the very elements that we have heard from today's gospel reading. It speaks about the sun, the moon, the stars, the powers in the heavens, okay? Even the fig tree. The seasons, the changing of times and seasons. Now, what do these things signify for all of us? Kung makadungog ta og kahayag, bulan, bituon, kalangitan, kapanahunan, what do this remind us? Simple. It brings us back to the very beginning. You know, all these things appeared right at the very beginning when God created the heavens and the earth. Okay? God created the firmament, the universe, the sun, the moon, the stars, and the denizens of the universe. Everything. You know, human beings, including us. So the end is really something that would bring us back to a start, to the very beginning. But it is not just a simple turnover of events or from one phase to another. Because aside from the stars, the moon, the heavenly bodies, there is one significant what we call focus. In fact, if we try to plot that the gospel reading today, naana siya sa tunga-tunga. It's in the middle part of the gospel reading of the text. And what is that? It is the fig tree. Now, what's so important about the fig tree anyway? Kahoy ra man adri. Wa man gani siguro ta anak diri pero si Sister Emma na ay fig tree gatagan gani ko niya no wa na lang ro namunga kay gikaon sa anay ang akoa. Anyway, what is the significance of the fig tree? It is the first tree witnessing to what happened with Adam and Eve in the garden. Okay, so if you like trivia, okay, fig tree is the very first tree mentioned in the Bible. That is Genesis chapter 3, verse somewhere there, no? So, mauna ang unang kahoy. And what was the event identified or connected with the fig tree? That's the time when Adam and Eve realized that they were naked because they disobeyed the commandment of God. And from that time on, God gave the judgment. So right from the very beginning of time, the judgment was already there. And so here we are also preparing ourselves for that. And the very witness to this is the fig tree. The fig tree whose leaves they used to cover the shame. The fig tree that was a witness to practically also God's kindness and goodness. That God has a way of putting things back into its right order, in its right manner. And the very heart of this putting all things back into order is by sending his Son, the Word incarnate. And this is the reason why at the end of that illustration in today's gospel reading about the fig tree, learning a lesson from it, it says there that heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will not pass away. And what are these words? Or who is this word? This word is the everlasting word. The word incarnate, our Lord Jesus Christ, who continues to speak to us. In the scriptures that we read, this is actually a very common balik-balik na nako ng isulti. In the scriptures we read, that if we read scriptures. In the sacraments we celebrate. In the many different realizations that we have, day in or day out when we reflect on the significant meaning of our lives and of the events that are happening around us. What it do to us, how it challenges us, how these things actually bring us into realization and a consciousness. That is why it's like a cycle. And I should say, if there is an end, there is always a beginning. We are back to the beginning. In the same way as when we say, if there is a beginning, there is also an end. But not only that, because it goes on and on in a cycle, in a positive approach, in a very inspiring manner, because if all things end, they also have their own beginning. From where? In the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth, God said the word, no? Let there be, and there was, and there is. And so as we continue with this Eucharistic celebration, putting in mind the subtle inspiration of really capturing and understanding the end. No? Usahin na abang gani uban ng mga expressions ng maingon, let that end. No? Sige lang, pasagdi lang, let it end. There is a new thing, a new beginning sprouting from that particular experience. And it is hopefully for the good. Because what God wants us is to see that in all these things, there is always goodness that comes. Because that good is the very beginning of everything. And again, we recall what is said in the book of Genesis, chapter 1, verse 31. When God saw, when He created the universe, the earth, with man, what is the text saying? And God saw that it was very good. Amen.